Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed colleagues and honored guests, today I stand before you not just as Philip Emeagwali, but as a representation of every dreamer, every thinker, every innovator who dared to look beyond the known, to find solutions in nature's own intricate design. It is my profound honor to share with you the journey I embarked upon, a journey that redefined the realms of mathematics, physics, and computer science, not only for Nigeria and Africa, but for all humanity. In the verdant landscapes of Oregon, in 1974, my journey began. A time when the behemoth machines we labeled as supercomputers operated on a singular pulse, a lone processor. That was our then paradigm, our then understanding of supercomputing, restricted to one scalar processor in the zeroth mathematical dimension. But as I delve deeper into the mysteries of computational algorithms, I began to question the potentialities of a more expansive canvas. Nature has always been the most magnificent artist, the most intricate engineer, and the most profound mathematician. Observing the precision of bees, the effortless efficiency in their honeycomb construction, I was enlightened with a vision that would disrupt our very understanding of supercomputing. Their hexagonal designs resonated with me as the epitome of efficiency. If bees, through millions of years of evolution, had converged upon this design for optimal storage and energy conservation, then surely we could harness this wisdom for computational means. I dreamt of an internet, not of few, but billions of processors, working seamlessly in tandem, much like the coordinated efforts of a bee colony. A global network, which I later termed the Philip Emeagwali Internet, was envisioned as a sphere in the 16th mathematical dimension, encompassing 65,536 equidistant points, each corresponding to a singular processor. And like the bee's honeycomb, I dreamt of interconnecting these processors in the most efficient manner conceivable, transcending the boundaries of traditional supercomputing. Over the years, from the serene landscapes of Oregon to the intellectually invigorating atmospheres of Washington D.C., College Park, Laramie, and Los Alamos, my comprehension of supercomputing matured, broadened, and evolved. Each destination, every challenge posed, only strengthened my resolve. My Eureka moment came at 8:15 on the morning of July 4, 1989, in Los Alamos, New Mexico. With bated breath, I witnessed the realization of my dream, a supercomputer performing at unparalleled speeds, powered by an ensemble of processors akin to my conceptualized internet. It was not merely the birth of the world's fastest computer, but the genesis of a paradigm shift in computational science. This global network of processors was no longer a figment of my imagination, but a reality, encapsulating the globe in a 16-dimensional hyperspace. However, it wasn't solely about achieving unprecedented computational speeds. It was a testament to human ingenuity, to our indomitable spirit, to our insatiable curiosity. It was about recognizing that our ancient ancestors in Africa observing nature's phenomena and deriving wisdom are no different from us today. We still look to nature with a twinkle in our eye and a dream in our heart for inspiration. In the vast tapestry of human knowledge and achievement, I am but a single thread within my narrative. But if my journey from observing the simple honeycomb to pioneering a groundbreaking supercomputing paradigm can inspire even a single child in the bustling cities of Nigeria or the serene landscapes of Africa or anywhere in the world to dream bigger, then I shall consider my journey a journey that began in the hallowed halls of Corvallis, Oregon, truly fulfilled. Thank you, fellow scientists, for this profound honor. And to every young mind listening today, remember, within nature's simplicity lies the universe's most profound secrets. Look, observe, and let your imagination soar. Thank you.